Hello and welcome to Your South Florida. I'm Pam Giganti. Civic engagement is the cornerstone of a functioning society and democracy, empowering people to contribute to and to shape their communities and governments in powerful ways. From local advocates and grassroots organizers to elected officials and volunteers, civic leaders come in many forms, but they all share a common goal: to drive positive change and uplift their communities. On today's program, we're exploring the vital role civic leadership plays in shaping the future and the programs empowering a new generation of leaders. That's why we're here at FIU's Maurice A. Ferre Institute for Civic Leadership, part of the Green School of International and Public Affairs. Named after former Miami Mayor Maurice Ferre, the Institute serves as a hub for fostering a more engaged and informed community. Through workshops, research, and forums, the Ferre Institute is helping inspire students to get involved in their communities and their futures.
The Maurice A. Ferre Institute for Civic Leadership was launched in 2021 to promote civic engagement and leadership, sustainable community infrastructure, and social justice. And we do that through academic, research, and community-oriented programs. In terms of academic, we have a certificate that's available both to undergraduate students and to graduate students in civic engagement and public management. We also have a free micro-credential that's available for students. We have a fellowship program. The students are able to participate in service learning projects. As well, we've been very successful in fundraising for scholarships. So Maurice Ferre is probably most well known for being the first Hispanic mayor of Miami. He was born in Puerto Rican and was the first Hispanic mayor of a major U.S. city. So he served as the mayor from Miami from 1973 to 1985 during some of Miami's most tumultuous years. He made sure to bring unity between the white, the black, and the brown communities. He was very progressive in the sense of social justice. He appointed the first black city attorney, and even went to the Department of Justice to help desegregate our Miami's police and fire departments. But before he was the mayor, he was also a state legislator, a county commissioner, and later dedicated his life to public transportation as the director of the Miami-Dade Transportation Authority. So on this rendering, you'll see that Maurice Ferre was one of the first to propose a tunnel underneath the Port of Miami in order to eliminate a lot of the traffic that was going through downtown. He was very visionary in the sense of not only realizing that to leverage federal dollars, that we had to work regionally. So working in collaboration with Miami-Dade, Broward, and Palm Beach County through the Tri-Rail and other transportations, we were able to leverage and make a more unified South Florida community. And I think what's really come about through the interviews that we've done with those who knew him and those who worked with him is how much he loved people and how much he loved Miami and how he really wanted to empower people to be civically engaged, to make a difference in their community. As a nonpartisan institute, we really focus on just education and letting voters to make their own informed decisions. This semester, we have a series called FIU Votes. Our first one focuses on Government 101 to explain the difference between the responsibilities of the local, state, and federal government. The second in our series is contacting your representatives. So we give students the tools on how to advocate and to reach their representatives to express their opinions. And then our final in our FIU Vote series is Your Vote, Your Voice, which ties voting to the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals so everyone can find an issue that really will drive them to the polls to make a difference.
Our number one goal is just to make sure that every young person feels confident, you know, when they're casting their ballot and they feel as if, you know, they're making the best and most informed decision they can. We'll always try our best to provide, you know, nonpartisan, you know, factual, educational information.
Today we hosted an event with the ACLU at FIU Student Club, and this was about explaining the Florida Constitutional Amendments Forum. So we had a representative from the Miami-Dade Supervisor of Elections Office, from the League of Women Voters, from Engage Miami, and from the ACLU to basically break down each amendment so that we could provide a clearer understanding of what a yes or no vote. Again, we don't want to tell anyone how to vote, but we want to make sure that they're able to make informed decisions.
For quite a bit few years now, Engage Florida has been a partner with FIU through the Ferre Institute. Through our partnership, we are regularly here at FIU registering young people to vote, making sure that their their voter registration forms are updated and their voter information is up to date. We also assist with vote by mail requests, and we help decode the ballot with them. since January until right now, we have registered over 2,000 students to vote this election cycle. We want to make sure that we put young people front and center, and if we're helping build their, you know, civic power through this partnership, you know, it's a win-win, you know, for FIU, but also the organization as well and the future of Florida.
My spiel to students is that, you know, although it may not seem like in terms of bigger elections, like presidential elections with the whole electoral college, that our vote may not count, but in local elections is where we really feel all of the ripples of, you know, voting and legislation. So I really encourage students to get involved and investigate and really, you know, invest their time in our future, because this is what we're really talking about. This is what is in our hand. Voting, legislation, the ballot, that's our future.
We don't just inform and say, come to our event or whatever, but they show up. We show up because we really want change.
Working with organizations like the ACLU and FYU Club and other organizations and students like Enrique and Genesis is really just heartening, because you see how motivated they are and how involved they are. And to be that role model for their peers and showing how they can move the needle. And really, it's all about just giving them the tools and the resources to feel like they can make their voice heard. Within the Green School and across FIU, we have affiliate faculty like Dr. Jose Morcillo Gomez from Modern Languages, who are really our liaisons out in the community and within our classes. So we want to be able to pull together the different units of the university to work together, bringing in faculty from different majors, from different programs, to inform students about the programs, but also give them an opportunity to get engaged.
The South Florida community, I think one of the landmarks is the diversity. It's a multi-linguistic community. It's a place where, during the history, especially from the 60s until now, everything changed. I would say that you cannot survive here if you are not able to communicate in the main languages that we have. Then, I think FIU and Instituto Ferre in this case, and the part that I am working now in my department in Modern Languages, we can bring together that big effort just to prepare. In the case of the leadership, you cannot be a really good leader here if you are not aware of that variety, of that diversity. We are professors, we have a big impact in our students, and that's why here in the School of International Relations and Public Affairs, SIPA, is helping the new leaders in the future, but not only in this community, but all over the world. And it makes sense to me to be in this college and being part of the Instituto Ferre. We are building up the new generations to come, and languages, that is my duty in this college, is a big part of that.
It is a privilege to serve in this position as the director of the Maurice Ferre Institute. Learning about Maurice Ferre through his archives, through our interactions with his family and for those that worked with him, it's about being a responsive leader. It's about caring about people and doing what you can, not just for your own personal well-being, but what's going to be for the betterment of your entire community. And we really want to prepare students to be the next generations of global leaders, whether it's here in Miami or across the country and across the world. We want students to realize that we're all in this together and that we should work together to make this a better future.
For more than 20 years, the city of Weston has been educating high school students about the inner workings of local government through a program called Weston University. Through this initiative, students get hands-on experience in all facets of city government, empowering students to engage with their community and learn what it means to be an active and informed citizen.
So good morning, welcome to the City of Weston. Weston University is perhaps one of our favorite programs that we get to do as city staff. Being able to teach students about what we do in local government is really, really great for us.
Today, we're here at the City of Weston with 20-some students from local high schools that are participating in Weston University. And it's the first introduction for these young adults into what municipalities do, how a local government is run. This program is in its 23rd year. It's the brainchild of our director, Ms. Denise Barrett Miller, and our previous city manager, who made a determination that it would be great to educate our local community, and starting at the ages of young adults in high school, so that we could educate them on what, you know, what it means to live in a city and how it operates.
Our goals were always to, one, provide information on local city services and local government, how to make a difference in your community, that you as an individual do have a voice, and how to use that voice, and then three, expose students to careers in public service that they might never have known otherwise existed. The students after today go to various departments, such as a day with fire, a day with police, which is Broward Sheriff's Office, a day with parks and recreation and landscape and public works, a day with zoning. They will look at site plans. They will go up on fire ladders. They will do just such a wide variety of hands-on activities that are not available or offered to the average person, so that they can see what it's like to be somebody in that department and see what they deal with every day.
I'm most excited to kind of further my understanding of the criminal justice system and stuff like that. I'm really excited to work with BSO because I'm already in their program for Broward Sheriff's Office Explorers, and expanding my knowledge of that, and then combining that with how the local government works with Broward Sheriff's Office, I find super exciting.
By far my favorite aspect is the simulation that they do at when they come into this chamber and they actually take city commission positions. Somebody's a mayor, somebody's a city manager, and they're given rural issues that our city commission has considered in the past, and they're asked to debate and make decisions on those. Having been through the program and understanding how government works a little better, it kind of informs their decision making, and it even gives them a little sense of what the pressure an actual elected official faces when they're on the dais trying to make decisions as representatives of the people. I get to see students who are absorbing the information, are asking good questions, and are being challenged a little bit about their preconceived notions about what government was. If they leave at the end just slightly more trusting of us, I consider that a victory.
The real success is when it culminates with our visit to DC. We visit, like, you know, Congress, we visit our congresswomen or our senators, and they're excited. It's a very different feel, the confidence they're sharing, the collaboration between them, how collegial they all are. Even today, some have shared that they're looking at military academies. Some may go on to be aides with local state representatives or like state senators. And I'm hoping that we're giving them the basis and foundation. Plus, anytime they have a question, they're always welcome to come back and ask.
I think you'll find, if you were to talk to all the staff, is this program lights their fire again about government. I mean, we do the work on a day in, day out basis, but when we can share what we do with the community, in this case, the students, and it's well received and they're engaged and they ask good questions, it makes what we're doing worth it.
We have had so many students come through. It has changed some career paths, opened doors. We see these young adults blossom into kids going off to college and then having the wherewithal and the knowledge to be involved in their community. We're not telling them that they need to stay in Weston and be involved. We're teaching them that wherever life leads them, this is how to be involved.
I started my career in local government through the City of Weston's Weston University program. I'm currently an employee at the City of Boca Raton. I've been there approximately 12 years. And in my current capacity, I am the Deputy Director of Municipal Services, and I'm also the City Civil Engineer. We were the first class of Weston University. Everyone was kind of learning as we went, which made it even more exciting because everybody that was part of the program at the time really wanted to be there. The civics education is not something that you learn about in your normal curriculum. It's something you kind of have to seek out. And when you start digging into it, you find that there's a whole world of government that exists that is not covered in your textbooks or in the media or in anything these days that kids are normally exposed to. And I think I'd always wanted to be part of the community, and I just really didn't know what that meant. And credit so much to Denise Merritt and Weston University for all of the opportunities, not only for my education, but for my career. I wouldn't be here today. I wouldn't be the civil servant that I am without the City of Weston and the Weston University program.
I think that over time, 23 years later, it's demonstrated that proven evidence that the students have gone through this program have gone on to be successful in their careers, whether they choose like working in as an elected official or in a municipality. It really has helped them hone their professional skills, and for that I think it's been very successful.
3 years ago, Mr. Decker tasked my department with creating a program for adults. It has been incredibly rewarding to see how many people sign up and the passion that they have for their city. It has been positive from day one. They want to learn more and more and more about every intricacy of every department, because you have people from all over the world, and in other countries, they don't have the access that they do here to their city government. And they find it fascinating that we would invite them in. And then they, in turn, go back into their neighborhoods and tell people where they can get correct information versus disinformation.
I strongly believe there is a natural distrust in government right now, not necessarily because of what's happening at the local level, but we're all lumped into the same conversation. Government is government to a lot of people. And so if we can introduce students and adults to actual people who work in government, who are charged with the goal of providing good services in a responsible way, and then we can show that that's exactly what we do, maybe we can start earning back some of that trust. But we just want to have a more informed citizenry. These young people coming up today are bright, they're energetic, I think they're well-intentioned, and if they're our future leaders, I have a lot of reason to be optimistic.
A program by the Belglade Chamber of Commerce called Leadership Glades brings together local professionals to learn about the community and develop the skills needed to address its unique challenges. Through workshops and hands-on experiences, participants gain valuable insights into areas like local government, education, and agriculture. Now in its 33rd year, Leadership Glades hopes to continue cultivating strong, committed leaders who are equipped to make a meaningful impact in the Belglade community and beyond.
The Glades communities are different than most urban communities that I've been a part of in Palm Beach County. It's certainly a more rural community, but it's got very deep roots. I meet families that are second, third, fourth generation in this community. I think there's a lack of knowledge for most of Palm Beach County about everything that happens in the Glades. This community is feeding America. It's feeding Palm Beach County. When you go into the grocery store, what you're buying, a lot of it is grown right here in the Glades area. There's always challenges when you get to a rural community with a diverse residency and seasonal residency in some cases, because we're agricultural based, where residents will move to other harvesting locations at other times during the year.
Good morning, Leadership Glades. I am here to welcome you all to the class of 2024-2025 Leadership Glades program.
Leadership Glades is a program for the Belglade Chamber of Commerce. Leadership Glades focuses not just on Belglade. Our program is focused on the entirety of the community. Leadership Glades originated in the 90s. It had some of the most widely known names in this community, members get together and say, you know, there's a lot happening in Belglade that a lot of people don't know. How can we help them get to know what's happening in the Glades? The program has run since because it's so well received. People that go through Leadership Glades find things out in the community that they've grown up in that they didn't know happened here.
I am from the Glades. I was raised in Canal Point and then in Pahokee, and thought that because I was raised here, went to school here, that I knew everything about the Glades. I was amazed to learn at all the inner workings of the different industries here in our community. I had no idea how far-reaching the judicial system was, even though my father was the judge out here for many years. Had no idea that we had a full-service courthouse out in the Glades. Had no idea how far-reaching the education system was out here.
The members in the class will get to see a lot of the different types of businesses that are operating out here. See really the connections and interconnections that these companies have often with agricultural businesses. We'll see how secondary education has been developed in a way to support industry needs in this community. The agricultural industry relies on the CDL programs for truckers that are a key component of agriculture that are held out here in the Glades area.
Since I've been with my career in the Glades, we have worked through Leadership Glades and some of the other organizations that graduates have been in to help reopen West Tech facilities to help bring jobs out for our community specifically. So a lot of great things have come out of the resources that we've built from the leaders that we've built in Leadership Glades.
The class members will see not just what's being grown, they're gonna see how it's handled after it's grown, how it gets from farm to table, if it's local, or farm to shipping, for some of the products that provide food sources for most of America. They'll see some of the social safety net resources that are available, that it's amazing how many people that have lived here their whole lives don't know or are available to them.
I work for Stein Sugar Farms. I'm a fourth generation farmer here in the agriculture area. I think when I was in the class, I was 34 years old and thought I knew everything, knew all about the community. It was a real eye-opener. You're in there seeing people in all, you know, facets of the workforce, and you get to know them, and that's a contact. I mean, with the sheriff department, with the hospital, with social services, and if you have problems, you can go to the people that are in the class and all. They become your friends, really helps in life, you know, to know people in different places. It opened a lot of doors for me, but I can't say enough for it. I would recommend it.
It is supporting emerging leaders, giving them the information that they need with the resources that are out in our community, understanding what industries are here, and by making the connections through networking and getting to know and build relationships with the people that are in their class. And then the value of that is when they leave and go on, they're able to be better advocates in our community for things that they need and to help bridge any gap there might be with connecting people to the resources that they serve that are available here in our community. And if they're not here in our community, how we can bridge the gap to the Eastern communities as well. I look around in the room as we have orientation every year, and it is amazing to me to see the fresh new faces. Our community is growing. We're crossing borders with diversification, and it is refreshing to be able to see that there's a need and a want for people to be connected.
We think that we've built a program that's durable, replicable, sustainable, and we really want it to continue to grow and thrive over the coming years. For people that aren't here full time, that maybe work out here but live in town, when they hear stories about what the perceptions of the Glades are, they can speak from a voice of confidence that they've been there and they've seen what's actually in the Glades, a very deep-rooted, strong culture that has many generations of commitment to feeding America and feeding Palm Beach County.
For more on civic leadership, follow us on Facebook at Your South FL. And for more community content, head over to our website, southfloridapbs.org/YSF. I'm Pam Giganti. As always, thanks for watching.
For more about our South Florida community, like, subscribe, and click the video below.